What is biological control? Biological control is the use of living organisms that are natural enemies, such as insects, mites, fungi, or bacteria to manage pests. Natural enemies are living organisms that are most effective when pest populations are low. Use natural enemies on a preventative basis, early in the cropping cycle, when plants are small and when pest numbers are very low. This is a completely different mindset compared to conventional pest control, waiting until you see the pest damage and then treat it with insecticides or miticides. What types of natural enemies are commercially available? Some of the more commonly used natural enemies include predatory mites for thrips and spider mites, host-specific parasitic wasps for whiteflies and aphids, and nematodes for fungus gnats. Parasitic wasps. Parasitic wasps lay their eggs inside the host and kill the host as the newly hatched larvae begin to feed. Parasitic wasps are very host-specific. For example, Encarsia formosa is used to manage greenhouse whiteflies. Predators. Predators tend to be more generalist feeders and are less host-specific than parasitic wasps. There are many different species of predatory mites commercially available that feed upon spider mites and or thrips. One example is cucumeris, used to manage western flower thrips. Entomopathogenic nematodes. Entomopathogenic nematodes are microscopic roundworms that enter the insect's body through openings in the exoskeleton. The nematodes multiply inside the host insect and release a bacterium that is toxic to the host. Pathogens. Pathogens include insect-killing fungi, such as Bulbaria bassiana, that use enzymes to dissolve the insect cuticle, using the insect as a food source. Advantage of using biological controls. Some of the advantage of using biological controls include less exposure to residues from pesticides by workers and staff. There are no re-entry intervals for biological control agents compared to pesticides, increasing access to greenhouse crops during busy production and shipping seasons. Improved crop quality with a lower risk of spray damage from pesticides. The use of biological control agents is an important practice to help prevent the development of pesticide resistance. Here are some steps on how to start a biological control program in your greenhouses. Gather resources. It takes time and commitment to learning the biology and life cycles of the insect and mite pests and their natural enemies. You must become familiar with the optimum environmental requirements like temperature and relative humidity needed by the different natural enemies. Review past pest problems. Know the species of pests with which you are dealing. Review pesticide use. Review your pesticide use for the past 3 to 4 months before starting biological control. Many insecticide residues, such as pyrethroids or organophosphates, can adversely affect natural enemies for up to 3 to 4 months after their application. Have a regular scouting program in place. Before beginning biological control, develop a regular, consistent scouting program. This helps you anticipate when the various pest populations are of concern, so you can plan to release the natural enemies in sufficient time. Transition into biological controls. Start in a small, isolated area or separate greenhouse as a trial area to learn how to use natural enemies before releasing them in your entire production area. Decide what crops and pests make the most sense for you to use biological controls. For a biological control program to be successful, needs the full commitment of the owner and manager and good communication among management and staff. Be diligent and patient. It takes time to develop a successful program. Use with proper cultural controls and sanitation practices. Start clean and stay clean. Remove pet plants and weeds. discard heavily infested plants. Keep garbage can covered. A fallow period with greenhouses completely empty of plant material of at least 4 weeks may help reduce pest pressure for the spring growing season. Have a plan. Biological control agents, especially parasites, are often specific to a pest or may be shipped in a stage that does not attack the targeted pest. Careful planning is needed before starting a biological control program. Start planning 6 months before. Establish a good relationship with your suppliers. Establishing a good relationship with your suppliers is critical. They want you to succeed, so should be able to supply you with technical information and advice. Ensure quality of natural enemies. Natural enemies are living organisms that must be handled and stored carefully to maximize survival and sustain their viability. In general, treatments of natural enemies should be received within 4 days after placing an order.